Howdy YouTube, and welcome to another Gunman Raw episode. So today we've got, it's actually the work ute. I did a little masking video on it a couple of days ago, and here we are. We're about to do the base coat stage. So I'll put you down here for a second while I put my respirator on. I like to wear my respirator when I'm doing my prep sole stage.
Oh man, it really started getting to me about a year ago, and like one of my friends always said to me, it was actually when we used to do weightlifting and that, he always said, always listen to your body, my friend, and that burning sensation in my nose was my body telling me to put a respirator on, even when you're doing prep soul. So these days, like when I'm out in the workshop, I've even got it on when I'm mixing paints up. I've pretty much got my respirator hanging around my neck most of the day. And it was getting to the point where even like of a night time, I was like sleeping, I was lying down in bed and I could still feel that burning sensation in my nose. It was actually getting pretty bad. That's the kind of thing that could, in fact, probably would lead to some kind of a cancer, and nobody wants that. Now, I've got to remember if there was any cut-throughs on this, because I started on this job, like, mid last week, and then the boss came and changed the plans, so I did have to leave the job for a few days and then come back to it. That's kind of danger territory, because you might have forgot, like I might have got like a little cut through there where I have to put color over, but I think I should be pretty right. Was there something down here maybe? There's something there. We're looking pretty good really. There's a little bit there I might put some color over too. On this job here, I'm going to be using the new clear that we've got. Well, it's not new, but we just started using it in this shop. It's the Standoff Extreme Clear. It's like K9500, I think that was the number. And we're coming from the Performance Pro Clear. That's what we were using previously. One thing I have noticed is that the Extreme Clear sort of wants to run on you, it's very thin. So we're using the extra flow hinder. He said, like the rep said, that he recommends using extra flow all year round. But I ordered him a slow instead of an extra flow to see if that can kind of help. Because as I say, I haven't had any major dramas yet, like in big, I haven't had big hangings yet, but it's just been like around edges and little things like that where I had a few little runs that I generally wouldn't have. So as long as I can get that sorted out, then I'm going to be really, really happy with this performance, with the Extreme Clear. Anyway, that's about it. I'm still ready to get a base coat now. Got the colour in the gun, blender in the other gun, colour is activated, blender is activated. Because you have to do that when you're spraying this this clear. You have to activate your base coat. Supposedly it's like an adhesion thing. Supposedly the Extreme Clear won't stick to it unless it's activated. That's what they tell me. Who am I to argue? I'll just see what I'm told. say 1.3. Yeah, no, it's actually the 1.2. I've been meaning to switch it over. But I think my 1.3 cap of fluid tip is at home. That's right. The 1.3 that I've got at work is for the Elegant, the Shell edition. If this was a lighter colour, I probably would have used chlorine reducer. But I use bars because I don't want to have to wait too long. And I'm not going to get muscle in a colour like this. I'd probably want to have gone a bit slower on that drop coat if this was like a silver or something. Yeah, I love the big fan and nice even big fan on this gun. But I reckon we can speed it up a bit with the 1.3. Especially coming into the warmer got to put harder in this Basecoat. It does actually make the Basecoat a little bit thicker. It is only 5%, so it's not as much as you have to put in when you're doing like an underhood. When you're doing an underhood cover, you have to do 10% to make it a bit more durable. But I think you're just putting the 5% in here more so for the sake of having like a hard surface. Like a harder surface. I think that's what the rep said to me. But yeah, it does stay a little bit different. It does slow the grind down a little bit right now. Not extremely. Today is a beautiful Melbourne spring day. The sun's out, so we've got low humidity, and it's gonna dry nice and fast, which is good because I got other stuff to do. There's another job out there, which I don't know exactly how it happened, but there's a bonnet that they painted the rest of the job, but then now we've got to paint the bonnet on the same cars, and it's going today. So I have to repair 3 or 4 dents in this bonnet to get this car to go. Alright, now we'll get that blender back out. I do actually have a bumper to paint on this car later, but you may note there's not much room in here already. I guess I could have squeezed it up there, but I didn't. Oh, that's right! I knew there was a cut through somewhere. Up the top of that door frame. I'm gonna have to put a bit of colour over that. That's easy though. They're little things like that, which is why it's kind of dangerous, like, leaving jobs halfway through. Generally, I like to sort of be left on a job, but it's alright. I guess I could have put, like, a little note up there. That would have been a good idea. But it's alright, I found it. Yeah, what a beast of a gun, eh? It says 1.3, but it's actually 1.2 on there. Do that blend first. Get that little bit of colour over there, like I mentioned. And then we'll just fill in the gap. Such a breeze, this stuff, man. It's just so easy, eh? It's just thin out. Like, when you first paint this, it's unlike any other paint system. Well, I mean, I think Galathra has kind of copied, but I don't think anyone uses Galathra anymore, so I think they've probably lost too many customers in the last sort of 10 years that, I don't know. Back in the solvent days, man, Galathra was the best, I reckon, eh? They lost their way when the water came. Anyway guys, we're just about done, so thanks again for watching as always. Thanks for being fans. We get that little bit there, yep. Then we'll do that drop coat. But yeah, that bumper is going to be easy to fit in with another job at a later date. I'll do that with another job, easy. But anyway guys, hope hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to give it a big thumbs up as always. And I'll see you in a couple of days for the clear coat bid.